is like enormous.
I am smaller than that. Because I my sword sticks in his shoe.
Can we put that away? Gulliver's scale is...
I'm 1/27 his size.
He's bigger than everybody else.
I'm not good at math.
I don't really know, is the answer to the question. All I know is we spend a lot of the film like that.
He's 120 feet tall to them, and they're about 4 inches tall to him. We should have made him 10 feet tall in retrospect. It would have been so much easier. 120 feet is just... it's insane. Dealing with Gulliver in our world is the most complicated thing, because he's not a CGI character that we put in later. It's Jack.
The fact that the film is based on the character Gulliver, who's 120 feet tall, lends itself to this sort of slightly more visual effects orientated environment.
I don't want to vanquish anybody, and you don't want to vanquish. Let's just get ahead, okay?
Of course, it starts with the script, and then it starts with the production design. And a lot of just meetings with Rob and some previs, and we just start to coalesce all the information together.
When I first started, I met with Rob, and one of the things, you know, we both wanted to do very badly is sort of take it to the next level.
Jack needs to interact with Jason, or Chris O'Dowd, or Emily Blunt, or whoever his scene is with. So it's a really complicated thing to get a sense that they're in a scene together when they're actually not. Completely separated on different stages and green screen.
This movie, we're breaking new ground technically. We're trying very kind of radical visual effects and camera techniques to do something very different in terms of introducing Jack as a giant into this world.
We really wanted the natural feel of two actors in the room together. And I think for comedy purposes, when they start ad-libbing or improvising, I just wanted to be able to capture that moment. So Jim Reigel, the visual effects supervisor, came up with this dual motion control system so that I could shoot the actors simultaneous with Jack.
We can shoot the Lilliputians with a techno crane, and we have another unit that's doing the exact same move, but 22 times smaller, which makes Jack look 22 times bigger. And so what's the beauty of it is you're getting the same lighting, putting in the same world, you're getting the same moves together, and literally you can almost just put the two on top of each other and it works.
We have on the monitor the two images are comped together in real time, and I can see the final image, and I'm able to direct them, and I run back and forth across the stage to give notes, and then we do it, and they can hear each other, and they can go, and it works really well. And we set these moving eye lines, and it's a much more fluid, much more organic way to do things.
Yeah, I'll just tell you what you switch or whatever. How come you're all turned around?
I mean, at first it was kind of like, how's this going to work, you know, because it's a lot of green screen, and we just get given an eye line, but Jack's got such a presence on set, like, just because of who he is, and so encouraging, and you really can't do it without him here.
It's testing at times when you're just staring at a piece of tape on a post that's been hoisted into the air.
It works fine, but sometimes he'll be talking behind you, but you're meant to be looking that way, and you're like, what? I think Billy had a problem with that more than anyone else.
I'm bored this way, and I have a real problem, you know, with Jack. When I'm talking to a piece of tape on the wall and his voice is coming from over here, because Jack's over there doing it. So I naturally, my brain just goes like that, to where he is, and my head follows. And I think I've been slower than the others in catching on to this.
But what's incredible is that Jack has come in every day, every single day, to just do lines off. That has helped so much, which has meant that any time when there's been points of, we thought, oh, maybe that's funny, maybe this, he's been there, so it's all kind of worked out then. And so then when it comes to shooting his bits on a green screen, he already knows quite where Horatio is, where the princess is, where Jinx is. That's been the biggest help.
Jack always shows up to do his off lines first thing in the morning, which I wouldn't do.
He's been incredibly generous and has been there for us every day to do off lines. He's been there throughout night shoots. He has a great essence about him, and he obviously thoroughly enjoys himself.
I'm so sorry if Mother embarrassed you.
Hey, no problem.
common mistake to not think I was president.
Rob has a tremendous amount of experience with his work on the DreamWorks films he directed, the animated movies, especially Monsters vs. Aliens, which has a lot of the scale issues that we have. And he sort of has the innate ability to sort of pierce through that scale challenge.
He thinks on his feet so well and so quickly. He works excellently with Jack, and he really had the sensibility as we developed the script how to take this into an interesting, fresh, and really funny way.
Rob, I honestly don't know how he does it. I genuinely don't know how he keeps his humor and stays relaxed, doesn't just want to explode all the time. I can't imagine what it feels like to just have the weight of this on your shoulders, you know?
Rob Letterman has been doing an incredible job. Every shot, basically, is going to have a special effect element with a giant and a tiny person. And to juggle all those things, just the logistics of this thing, it's like a Rubik's Cube of a movie. And to also be sensitive to the performances, it takes a very focused mind, and he's got it.
Mr. Beast! I've instructed our builders to work day and night to ensure you are seaworthy by week's end! Isn't that just the most fantastical news you've ever received in your life?
Great.
I can't tell you how happy I am!
The state-of-the-art accomplishment that we hope to achieve on this movie is when you see this movie, we don't want you to be aware of any trickery. We don't want you to be thinking, how do they do this, how do they do that. We don't want your eye to pick up any imperfection. Jack is a huge giant, and these are little people. They're going to be acting together. They're going to be in the scenes together. And the technology we've assembled allowed us to do that. And if you see this movie and you're aware of nothing, if you believe and lose yourself in this world and in the characters, then we've accomplished what we needed to.